Alberta is sending a Liberal to Ottawa, and he's from Calgary, splintering the solid blue canvas once sprawling over the heartland of Conservative country.
We got to put partisanship to the side and focus on delivering for our city and province.
The Tories grip easing some in Edmonton, with two New Democrats heading to Ottawa. While the bulk of Alberta MPs are still CPC, support is starting to sag, some wasting no time pointing the finger of blame squarely at the Premier and his handling of the pandemic.
I think it played a significant role. I don't know how you can look at a federal Conservative campaign that increased its popular vote, that picked up seats outside of Alberta and lost seats within Alberta, without looking at the effect that the Premier had and the connection between the O'Toole team and the provincial government.
Aaron O'Toole refused to even mention Jason Kenney by name during his campaign. The Premier's popularity has plummeted, and there are even calls for a leadership review from members in his own party as the province battles another deadly fourth wave.
I believe that the leadership in this province has been wanting. It's been all over the map and inconsistent. It's clear that Albertans and party members cannot trust him.
On Tuesday afternoon, Kenney decided to shake things up, swapping out his health minister. The timing, no coincidence, but this political analyst says the federal election results are not why.
Having stuck with the health minister for this long and only replacing him on the eve of a caucus meeting that is rumored to have a non-confidence motion at it really does suggest that the premier is throwing Minister Chandreau under the bus in an attempt to save his own career.
There is another factor that could have weakened Tory support in Alberta. While they didn't win a seat, the People's Party of Canada got a little over 7% of the popular vote here. Further proof of a shift in a province often reluctant to change. Jamie Dahl, Global News, Edmonton.